Hi everyone, welcome back to Ignite. My name is Kelly Kaye, Senior Community Program Manager for Power BI. We're thrilled to be back with you to share the exciting new features we have in store for Power BI that will help you create reports and collaborate more efficiently. To talk us through these features, with me today I have the amazing Kim Manis, Partner Director of Product Management for Power BI and Synapse. Welcome, Kim. It's great to have you with us today.
Thanks for having me, Kelly. I'm really excited to be here. Since we last met at Build, we've worked on an array of exciting new features for Power BI. I want to highlight four main announcements with you. Let's start by looking at SharePoint and Onedrive. Over the past couple of years, we've released some truly game-changing integrations with Microsoft 365 apps like Teams and PowerPoint. Continuing on this trend, we're announcing the ability to explore and interact with Power BI reports directly from SharePoint and Onedrive. As you can see in this demo, instead of saving reports to your local drive, you can now save your reports directly to a cloud location in Onedrive or SharePoint. Once saved, you can then explore and interact with the report while in Onedrive or SharePoint without needing to publish to the Power BI service. This integration not only makes it easier to share Power BI reports, it also allows a faster time to insight for business users who are more comfortable with SharePoint or Onedrive. I'm also thrilled to announce a couple of features that will make cross-organizational collaboration and report sharing even easier and more fruitful. Cross-tenant dataset sharing and business-to-business discoverability. These features make it easier to access and filter external datasets, reports, folders, metrics, and other artifacts all in one place. Let's take a look at a demo. Cross-tenant dataset sharing enables you to collaborate on datasets with external organizations in a fast and secure manner. When you share a dataset from your tenant with an external user, they can access it in their own tenant, create composite models on top of the shared dataset with their own data, and then build reports based on that model. They can even access all their external datasets in one easy-to-find place in Power BI Desktop. Along with this dataset sharing, we're also adding a new tab on your Power BI service homepage called From External Orgs that will make it easier to find reports, datasets, and other items shared with you by external users. You can even filter and sort through this list quickly to find what you're looking for. We're also releasing a set of tools in a new ribbon called Optimize that will help you build reports faster, especially when working with direct query reports with large data models. The new ribbon in Power BI Desktop includes options to pause and refresh visual queries. This way, you can change field list items to a visual without the visual updating, or refresh individual visuals one at a time. The tab also has optimization presets for query reduction, interactivity, and the ability to add your own customized preset. Additionally, if you go into your data model, we've added the ability to edit relationships using the properties pane. In May, we announced an automated migration tool that helps accelerate the migration experience from Azure Analysis Services to Power BI Premium. To give some context on why you should consider using this migration tool, we've worked hard to bring the powerful Azure Analysis Services enterprise modeling capabilities to Power BI Premium over the past few years. The Power BI Premium functionality now goes far beyond the comparable functionality available in Azure Analysis Services or on-prem SQL Server Analysis Services. Here, we can show you how easy it is to migrate your Azure Analysis Services workloads to Power BI Premium using this migration tool. Those who migrate can enjoy improved performance and reliability of Power BI Premium's Gen 2 distributed architecture, simplified discovery, and management of datasets, and a host of additional features, workloads, and capabilities only available in Power BI Premium. The four features I showed you only represent the tip of the iceberg. We have several other announcements we know you'll love, including the inclusion of Power BI as part of the Office 365 installer, which will reduce deployment effort and time for IT. The ability to embed metrics in Power BI across your applications to drive alignment. A Power BI embedded SDK to deploy your own quick create experiences for your customers in your own applications. Contextual on-object controls for Power BI visuals, the ability to edit data models on the web in the Power BI service, enhancements supporting reports with large data sets, and lastly, the ability to add Power BI reports and datasets as Dataverse components in Power Apps solutions. Now I'll hand it back to Kelly to share how you can learn more and get started with all these features. Back to you, Kelly.
Thank you so much, Kim, for walking us through these exciting new features today. And if you want to learn more about everything Kim announced today, please visit the Power BI blog and check out the Ignite announcement, which talks about these features in more detail and provides you with links to additional resources. We look forward to joining you at these Ignite sessions where you can see many of these features Kim talked about today in action. As always, thank you all so much for helping us create such an amazing Power BI community. Your active engagement has helped us make Power BI what it is today. And as always, we'll meet you in the community.